Are you a Power BI developer who works with many different data sources or requires dynamic filtering in Power Query? If that sounds like you, I have a very interesting topic for you today. Power Query, query parameters. Hi, I'm Sohail Bakhshi, a Microsoft Data Platform MVP, with a very warm welcome from biinsight.com. If you are a seasoned Power BI developer, you might have already heard about query parameters in Power Query, and you might already know about how powerful they are. But there are some intricacies. I have written multiple blog posts about query parameters in the past that I put the links in the description below, and I also discussed the importance of query parameters in my book, Expert Data Modeling with Power BI, which I also put the link in the description below. In this video, I'm talking about a very specific intricacy of query parameters. Some users may have already noticed that their query parameters actually do not show up on Power BI service, or even though they show up in Power BI service, they are not editable. They are simply grayed out. Have you also faced this issue? If that's like you, that is exactly what we are going to find out in today's video. Let's begin. Okay, let's say I have two data sources. One is AdventureWorks DW2022 USA, and the other one is AdventureWorks DW2022. I am a developer and I want to build my data model based on AdventureWorks DW2022 USA, which have those tables, right? So I will bring those tables into my data model, but I would like to be able to switch between the databases later. So I need to use query parameters in Power Query. So let's create a new solution in Power BI Desktop and parameterize the queries and see the issue that we may face. Let's start a new solution in Power BI Desktop. I want to connect to my Azure SQL database, so I need to have the server name and the database name. So I go straight to Transform Data to open Power Query Editor. And from there, I quickly define two new parameters. I click on Manage Parameters. Then I click on New, change the parameter name to Server. I need a parameter for my server name, and I copy and paste my server name from Azure portal over the current value. And I'll create another parameter. Let's name it database and save my database name on the current value here. And click OK. Now, let's go ahead and connect to the database and grab some tables. To do so, I just click on the new sources from here, and then I go to the Azure category, and the first one is Azure SQL Database. I click connect. As you can see, I have the option of using parameters or just type in the database name and server name. I use the parameters. So I click the drop down button and use server for the server name and database for the database name, and I click OK. Since it is an Azure SQL database, I can use the database credentials or a Microsoft account. I stick to my database credentials. And then I click connect. I just select some of the tables that I have on both databases. From those tables, I select in product, in date, and factory seller sales. Those three are enough for our example. I click OK to get the tables in my Power Query. If we look at the source step of these queries, you will see that the query is actually parameterized. It gets the server name from our server parameter and the database name from the database parameter. Let's click close and apply to load some data in our data model. Now the data is being loaded in Power BI Desktop, and we can see edit parameters. We can edit the parameter names here. So I can change the server name and the database name. The entire underlying query will connect to this server and the database name and fetch the data into the data model. Let's click OK. Query has been changed. Click Apply. Now goes through credentials again. So I pass my credentials. Okay, now we are going to publish this data model into Microsoft Fabric and see what happens in Microsoft Fabric. So before I continue, I have to save this. And now I publish the model into Power BI service. Now let's head to Microsoft Fabric and see what happens there. I select Power BI and then select my workspace. Now let's say that I want to switch the query parameters from a server or a database to another. To do so, I need to hover over the semantic model and click the ellipsis button and then settings. You may see this issue, which is failed to connect, so you have to pass your credentials. Do not forget to select the privacy level and let's click sign in. Okay, so that solved that problem. And now let's change the parameter. There is a parameters section in the semantic model settings that I can expand, and I can see two query parameters are added, but they are not editable. They are grayed out. Why is that? The root cause of this issue lies within the definition of query parameters in Power Query. Let's head to our solution in Power BI Desktop to see what the issue is. Okay, on Power BI Desktop, I click on Transform Data, go to Power Query Editor, I click Manage Parameters. The data type of the query parameter is any. As you may know, any is a data type in Power Query, which is used when you don't know the data type of a column. It is possible to have values with multiple types in a column in a table in Power Query. So the any data type is useful to deal with those situations. But at the end of the day, Microsoft Fabric and Power BI service, if you like, do not like the any data type. Let's change the data type of the query to text and database, change data type to text, click OK, and then click close and apply. And after the data is being loaded, I just save the solution and publish it again to the same workspace. I click replace to replace the data model with the new one. Now let's head to Microsoft Fabric again and hit the refresh button to refresh the semantic model settings page. Let's see what we have in parameters. Now the parameters are editable. So if I pass the server name and database name, it will work. And I click apply and that would be it. If you haven't passed your credentials already to the data source, you may need to do that again here. I have passed the credentials before, so I don't need to do that. As you saw in this video, the data type was the actual culprit. And data types in Power Query are a very, very important and big topic. Let me know in the comment section below what you think. Would you like to know more about Power Query queries? Or any other topics related to Microsoft Fabric and Power BI, just let me know and I will do my best to prepare a video about the topic that you asked for. I hope you have learned something new in this video and catch you in the next one.